Rock mining is a fantastic way of earning credits in Star Citizen, and it's also very accessible, including to new players. It's quite common to earn 200,000 Alpha UEC per hour through this method, and that can be a fantastic springboard to different things. I'm Farrister, and this video will cover the basics that will get you started with rock mining in Star Citizen as at patch 3.19. To begin with, you'll need to have a rock mining rover and a ship to transport it around, or enough credits to rent what you don't have. Both can be rented from an L1 refinery deck for less than 40,000 Alpha UEC for a Cutlass Black and rock for a day. This guide assumes you're also familiar with spawning and flying your ship. Next, you need to decide where you want to mine. Hadanite is the usual preferred material, which makes Daymar around Crusader or Aberdeen around Hurston popular choices of destination. Once you know where you're headed, take your transport ship to the moon and look for an outpost to load up your ground rover. You're looking for something with a blue landing pad with a building next to it so you can spawn in the rock. Once you've spawned your rock and loaded it aboard your transport ship, you need to scan for mineables. At this point, I'd recommend flying back to orbit and then manually flying the ship down to the moon's surface, somewhere off the beaten path. OM1 can be quite a good starting point as it's often great for daylight. Mostly, you want to avoid other players whilst you're doing this, as you're an easy target. Once you're near the planet's surface, keep your speed under control and press Tab to enter the scanning mode. You can then use left click to initiate a scan ping. You may well get lots of returns. You're looking for things that pop up at close range, within 3 or 4 kilometers. The scan modes can pick up bigger ores designed for a prospector or mole, which can be identified by the ore-like symbol. But you're looking for smaller mineables, identified by a gemstone diamond-like symbol. Fly closer to investigate them. Hadanite can be identified by its red tint or by hovering over the gems once you get close, and it's what most people stop for. If there are more than 4 or 5 rocks, it's probably worth stopping, otherwise you might be better to fly on and keep searching. After you've found a good cluster of rocks, it's time to unload the rock and start mining. Press M to enter mining mode and move the mouse over the first rock. This will show the mining user interface. Left click to activate the mining beam and control the intensity with the mouse wheel. The name of the game here is to charge up the rock until it's in the green zone and then keep it there, not putting too much power in to get into the red zone, but also not letting it fall back down below the green zone. You do this by modulating your mining intensity with the mouse wheel. After the bar fully charges in the green zone, the rock will crack. Don't let it get into the red zone, and if it does, maybe just back off. If the rock explodes, it can damage your rover, which can put an end to your run. There's also an optimum range on the top left of the display, although in practice it's usually best to get close. After the rock is broken, hit the right mouse button to enter extraction mode, and then left click to activate the laser, hovering over the little gems long enough for them to move into your inventory. Then rinse and repeat until the rock is nearing full. Whilst in extraction mode, it's easy to see how full the rock is, as there's a handy readout on the top left, as well as a charge bar on the right, which shows visually. When your rock is full, you can either transfer the inventory to your cargo ship and keep mining, or usually best bet is to get that cash in the bank before something awful happens by heading to a mining outpost via quantum travel to sell up. Head into the building marked storage, which is usually the one with the tower outside it, then head to the console, select your Grey Cat rock or your transport ship, and then sell them. A full rover worth of Hadanite is worth about 220,000 Alpha UEC, and usually takes between 1 and 2 hours to fill up. There you go, it's as simple as that. There's definitely more that you can learn and practice, and if you want to get more into mining and want to find out more, I'd highly recommend Red Monster Gaming for a load of fantastic mining resources, including the mining cheat sheets you can see on screen. Otherwise, I hope you found this video useful, and look forward to hearing in the comments about your big mining scores. If you'd like to see more videos like this, you might subscribe to the channel to give YouTube the prompt to show you more, as well as clicking the like button to let me know I should make more guide videos like this. Otherwise, I'm Farrister, and thank you for watching.